Hello everyone, I'm Alexander Gumrayan and I'm a web developer at Turris. Today I want to tell you something about our administration interface called reForis. Why reForis? What does the name mean? And why do we need our own administration interface and what are the benefits of it? I will try to answer all these questions and I hope it will be useful or not only for beginners. Okay, let's move on. Let's talk about motivation and why do we need an administration interface. As you probably know, Turris OS, Turris Operating System, is running on all Turris devices. It stands on the popular Linux distribution called OpenWrt with our software, modifications and improvements, such as Turris Sentinel, updating system, NetMetr, VPN services, and so on. So you can see it on the abstract image on my screen and understand how it is organized. OpenWrt by itself is open source, and in other words, it is developed and reviewed by many professionals from all over the world. As with Turris products, it means that the community and, of course, you can influence its future. For example, you can request a feature on our forum or report a bug on our GitLab. By the way, we really appreciate users' feedback and contributions. So, OpenWrt has its own administration interface called Luci or Luci, and it looks like this. As you can see, Luci is not very user-friendly and may scare a novice user. To tell the truth, I'm not very good at it and I can get lost there too. So, in order to make it simple and quick for all users, we have developed our own administration interface. Back in history, when Turris was a research project, there was no administration interface at all. It was just a wizard. You know, just a quick internet setup thing. But with time and more written code, it transformed into Foris administration interface. You can see how it looks on the screenshot. Historically, as I said, a wizard that had the main purpose to onboard users and accompany them to Luci. The name Foris has Latin origins and means door, gate, entrance. This is a previous web administration interface. It is available on almost all Turris routers. The exception is Turris Shield. And it was originally written using technologies that unfortunately almost ceased to death. It was Compass, Ruby CSS framework, and Bottle. It's a Python web framework. The latest Foris is written mostly in Python, JavaScript, and custom style sheets, which then led to inconsistencies in UI, problems with code maintenance, modularity, and mobile responsiveness. Then we come to reForis. It's a next generation redesigned Foris user administration interface. It looks like on the picture, and is available on Turris OS 5 and above, including Turris Omnia, Turris Shield, Mox, and Turris One after migration to Turris 5. reForis is written in Flask, React.js, and Bootstrap framework with the Bootswatch theme Flatly and Turris primary color. You can ask me when to use Foris and reForis. Currently, we recommend using reForis on all Turris devices because we will get rid of Foris soon and probably reForis will replace it. So you can help us with testing. Okay, let's move on and interfaces. Let's imagine that we bought a new Turris Omnia and the first thing that user will see is reForis wizard or guide. reForis wizard or guide mainly consists of three parts. It's a guide steps on the top, guide helper with the description text and control buttons, and the respective settings page. To mention that reForis guide has different workflows, it depends on your setup, but we recommend to use just router workflow. After going through the reForis wizard, you will see a reForis interface itself. It consists of three parts too. On the left you can see the navigation sidebar, in the top right corner information command panel, and the page itself. The last interface very interesting is the web apps page. It is our list of available applications from which you can easily navigate wherever you want. It has a default app where users will be referred after a certain period of time, and there will appear some other applications after installation, for example, NetData, transmission, etc. We have already a Turris Academy session number 3 with my colleague Joseph. He perfectly went through it, so you can check it, don't forget. Just to mention that web apps, different devices have different applications in web apps. So for example, Shield has only reForis administration interface. And for today, I have prepared for you some how-tos. I think the first one, we can skip it. It's pretty simple. It's just a setting up of a Wi-Fi access point. But I want to show you, for example, how to set up a guest network on my LAN, on my Turris Omnia.
Okay guys, let's imagine that my friend asked me to live at my apartment for a while. So I want to set up one of my LAN ports on my Turris Omnia as a guest network, which is separated from the LAN network. What are the benefits of a guest network? The benefits are that devices connected to the guest network are allowed to access the internet, but aren't allowed to access other devices and the configuration interface of the router. So first of all, I want to go to the Turris administration interface, reForis. The default address is 192.168.1.1. Here I wanna go to reForis. And log in under my credentials, and I want to turn up a guest network, so I will go in the menu network settings, guest network, enable guest network, and save the settings. Let's wait a bit. As you can see, I have a warning here that tells me that I should assign a network interface to this guest network. So I want to go to interfaces. Here you can see different groups of interfaces. For example, one, you have only one port, several LAN ports here. Guest network is empty, and unassigned one Wi-Fi module is unassigned. So I want to set up my LAN 1 port as a guest network. So I choose it and set guest network. You see, now line 1 port is under guest network group and it disappears from LAN. So I want to save the settings. Let's wait and apply the new settings. So it's under guest network, the state is good. Let's check the guest network tab here. No warnings, no errors. So good job, we set it.
Okay, and for the last example, we will see the installation and setup of NetMetr plugin.
Install the NetMetr plugin and set up an autorun to periodically benchmark our internet connection. What is a NetMetr? NetMetr is a tool, service, in our case, for measuring the actual quality of internet access services. In other words, to measure internet speed, download, upload, ping, etc. By the way, it's a Sentinel open source project, so you can find more information at netmetr.cz. So again, first of all, we should go to the reForis administration interface. The default address is 192.168.1.1. Then we should go to reForis, log in under our credentials. One moment. Okay, so then we should go to the package management, packages, find the network monitoring and parental control package list, check it, then check internet connection speed measurement. This is the NetMetr itself. Save it. And let's wait until all necessary packages and files will be installed. On our overview, the NetMetr card appeared and we received a notification of successful installation, reForis NetMetr plugin, and some dependencies. Okay, let's go to the NetMetr speed test. Here we can see the speed test of itself. Let's start it. It took a while to measure. So, successfully, speed tests finished successfully. We have our results. We can visit details on netmetr.cz. And as I said, we want to set up auto start to periodically benchmark our internet connection. So I wanna check midnight, 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. So let's save this. Just to mention that the requested time is approximate. The measurement will start about the selected hour. So the time is not accurate here due to load distribution. on our servers. So we can test again, and that's all.
Okay, to sum up, the administration interface is an important part of every router. ReForis is our latest, simple, and most user-friendly interface that brings a lot of for users, new design, improved notifications, improved mobile responsiveness, and for developers, modern architecture, modularity. Okay, guys, I hope you liked it. Don't forget to give a like and comment below. Okay, thank you for your attention. Follow us and have a nice day. Bye.